Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can swap values of two 1D arrays using call by reference in C++. Before starting, you can subscribe my YouTube channel by clicking on the link which is available at bottom right corner of this video. You can download my app TagImage that is available on Google Play. You can connect with me by following these details which are available in front of you. Now you can see a code which is implemented in front of you. First statement is comment, which is showing swap values of two arrays using call by reference in C++. Then I have included header file iostream. Then I have used a namespace std which is defined in iostream. This namespace I have used for cin and cout. Then class array is defined. It is containing an array, integer type array, which is of 5 size. Then public access specifier. So this array is private, and after public section, read, print and swap, these functions are declared. So these functions are in public section. So we can access these functions inside main function. So read function, print function and swap, three functions are declared here. Swap is receiving one argument, but read and print are not receiving any argument. After termination of class, first I have defined read function. So inside read function, you can see return type, then name of class, then scope resolution operator, then read is the name of function. Inside its definition, variable I is declared, then a loop is repeating 5 times from 0 to 4, and with the help of cin, I am reading values of array. After implementation of read function, print function is defined. It is similar to read, but it is using cout instead of cin. So it will be displaying elements which are available inside array, and handle is used to terminate the line. So each element will be displayed on new lines. Then next function, swap, is defined here. Inside swap, one argument is received, that is x. X is formal argument here, which will receive the value of explicit argument that will be passed from main function. Then two variables I and T are declared. With the help of this for loop, I am going to swap values of two arrays. So this A of I is representing implicit argument, and this X dot A of I is representing explicit argument. So first study this main function. Here two arrays are declared, A1 and A2. Then cout will display enter first array message on console. Then a1.read function is called. This will read first array. Similar to first array, second array will be read using a2.read. Then this statement is important. Here a1.swap a2 statement is written. A1 is implicit argument and a2 is explicit argument. So this a2 will be passed inside this x, and x will be representing a2 here. So when we implement call by reference by using this ampersand sign in formal argument, then memory of explicit argument, here A2, memory of A2 will be shared by this X. So whatever change we do in X formal argument, that will be automatically applicable for A2, because both are sharing same memory location, and A1 is passed implicitly, so we can access it here directly. So this AI and this AI is representing implicit argument, that is A1, and this X.A of I and this X.A of I is representing this X, which is sharing the memory of A2. So in short, we can say that A1 and A2 values are swapped using these three statements. After completion of swapping, using A1.print and a2.print, all the elements of arrays will be displayed on console. So after this explanation, I am executing this code. It is asking for first array elements. So I am entering 1 in first array, and I am entering 2 in second array. You can see the result. Values of first arrays are now 2, and values of second array are now 1. So with the help of this example, I have changed the values of sorry, I have swapped values of two 1D arrays and I have followed the method call by reference in C++. I hope you have understood this concept well. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can subscribe my YouTube channel, that is Sanjay Gupta _Tech School. Thank you for watching this video.